talk about Chase Daniel real quick. Okay. Hey, I'm gonna teach you defense this session, but I have to learn the offense here. I want you to understand a couple of things. One, this is not practice. This is school. You're at school. Okay. This is a place of learning. Right, we're teaching you a system where one thing leads to another, leads to another, leads to another. Okay, with that system, right, we're going to teach you defense. If you understand defense, and it's going to make you understand offense, we've got to do better. You understand offense, you understand defense, but you got to try to stop. So I really need you guys to understand all these different positions so we can be really the most knowledgeable wrestler we can possible. Okay? Now, chase the ankle. Chase the ankle. I see that you guys understand the concept, but there's a couple flaws here that we come up with key points. One, a lot of you guys are shooting and you're ending up on two knees. So you'll go like this. You'll shoot and you'll go right here. He sprawls, let's roll. And you're like this right here. You're gonna pump your left hand, right? Maybe you go to that, your left hand's here. And then you run around the guy like that, and then you try to finish. And it's really actually really, really hard. That's really hard to do. There's a lot of weight on me, right? It's hard for me to move my feet in that position. Like that all started, all the bad things that happened there, right, started because I wasn't close enough. So, you guys, your right hand, a lot of you, right, was wrapping or was right here behind his knee like this. Right, my right elbow, and I'm sure Coach said this, my right elbow needs to wrap elbow deep. Did Coach say elbow deep, bend the elbow, bend the knee? I'm sure he did. Okay. So, the bend of my elbow needs to bend his knee. What's preventing a lot of you guys from doing that, when I said chase angles, if you guys were out here like this, you were this far away. So you take this small little step here, and as you penetrate, even before he does anything, you're already like this. So my arm's already extended, so it's not elbow deep on the middle of his knee, right? I've got to get closer, my knee's got to be like right here, so I can wrap like this, in this position. And now, how do I get closer? I just, before the shot, I have to make sure my head's in the pocket. So my head is going to be right here. So if I change level, look how close I am. All right, I'm right here to hit that shot. Second, so it really starts there, then it continues on, right? You guys weren't getting your elbow to the mat. You weren't getting your elbow to the mat because your arm wasn't elbow deep, right? Next, you guys weren't swinging your trail leg. It goes back to being too far away again, but if I don't move my trail leg, I end up on two knees, and I end up on two knees, you're going to see all the different defensive things that we're going to do to beat the guys hitting the shot. So make sure you swing that trail leg. Right, when we swing the trail leg, what we do is this. We pull in and down, we swing our left foot, and our right hand goes over our left, and it keeps that weight right here on the elbow. All my weight's on that elbow. And what that elbow's doing, that elbow's a block, okay? And it blocks him from squaring up and sprawling. It stops him from moving. So it's not really a race. It's not, okay, I'm gonna spin, and you're gonna spin, and we're gonna see who spins faster. It's, I'm gonna stop you from moving, and I'm gonna get behind you, all right? So it's not really like if you're faster than the guy or not, it's if you control him, all right? So that's what we're trying to achieve with that. Now, McElwavy, okay? When I do a McElwavy, what direction am I trying to get his weight? Forward, okay. I'm trying to get his weight forward to relieve pressure on the wizard. Does this make sense to you guys? Okay, so here's what he's doing, right? I'll be the defensive guy. Mario shoots, and the guy drops down like this, right? He's gonna wizard. He's gonna grab his own chin, he's gonna wizard. And all his weight is going back towards his heels here, his butt's on his heel. And what's happening is, it's not allowing Mario to beat this wizard here. So what Mario does is he tries to get weight forward, right? As he bumps me with his hip here, what happens, notice, I had to post my right hand. My weight's going forward. Now I'm not sitting back on my heel. Now there's space in between my leg, all right, and my arm, and he can lift that arm free and score. So he gets my weight forward so he can lift the arm free. So the finish does what the setup should have done, okay? When you shoot or chase the ankle, right, we're trying to get his weight forward. So as I shoot or chase the ankle, I want Mario's weight to come this way as I go to the side. Let me show you. So if I'm here, I want to pull up to here. Now look, as I pull, notice there's no weight here on his heels. Mario's weight went forward, so it's easy for me to turn the corner and finish behind. Okay? I need you guys to understand these concepts. If you do, then it's not just you go out there and you try real hard and you shoot and then, you know, whatever happens, happens. You need to understand the technique. You need to understand why you do the things you do and what we're supposed to do. right? I think you guys are all working very hard. Yeah, I saw everybody out there trying really hard. I don't want, if you're gonna try real hard, let's try hard to do it right. Let's do it right and work hard instead of, you know what, do it halfway right and work hard and then it doesn't work. Listen, you guys are always gonna work hard in wrestling. You're always gonna work hard. The match, 6 minutes, whether you wrestle technically smart or technically stupid, you're still gonna exert the same amount of energy, all right? It just, the match just gets a lot easier if you can do it technically right. So then all that hard work you're putting in, you just get a lot more yield out of it.